Let's take a look at the different types of tracks you can use in Live. In Live, tracks host clips and also manage the flow of signals, as well as the creation of new clips through recording, sound synthesis, effects processing, and mixing. The session and arrangement view share the same set of tracks, with the first track in the session view corresponding to the first track in the arrangement view. The only difference is that in the session view, the tracks are laid out in columns, while in the arrangement view, they are stacked vertically with time moving from left to right. Each track has its own individual detail view, where you can add things like instruments, effects, or plugins. In the detail view, the signal flow of the devices that you might have added goes from left to right. A track can only play one clip at a time. When you trigger a new clip, the clip that was previously playing stops to let the new one play. At any one time, a track can be playing either a clip in the session view or a clip in the arrangement view, but never both. There are three types of tracks used in Live: audio tracks, MIDI tracks, and return tracks. Audio tracks are used to record and playback audio clips, whereas MIDI tracks are used to record and playback MIDI clips. Audio and MIDI tracks have their own corresponding clip types, so an audio clip cannot be hosted in a MIDI track and vice versa. Return tracks differ from audio and MIDI tracks in that they don't host any clips. Instead, signals from audio and MIDI tracks can be sent to a return track in order for mass processing. Then, this processed signal from the return tracks can be sent to the master or elsewhere. To add a track, right-click into the empty space and select the kind of track you want. You can add tracks with their respective shortcuts as well. For an audio track, Command-T on Mac or Control-T on Windows. For a MIDI track, Command-Shift-T on Mac or Control-Shift-T on Windows. And for a return track, Alt-Command-T on Mac or Alt-Control-T on Windows.